If you're looking to master Skyslope and streamline your real estate transactions, this is the video you've been waiting for. You might have heard other agents doubling their efficiency with Skyslope, and I'm here to show you the exact steps to achieve that. Over the past year, my team and I have tested and refined the best strategies for using Skyslope. Today, I'll share the exact workflows and techniques top performing agents are using. Stick around and I'll share with you exclusive Skyslope checklist my team uses. So get ready to elevate your game. Let's dive into the tutorial.
All right, so once you're logged in to Skyslope, this is the first page that you're going to see. So you'll see here, top right will be apps. You also have a printer, help, search, and then this will lead you to your profile or to your account profile. And then you'll have here a quick summary of all your transactions. And you'll see here one, two. So you have here 10 different subfolders inside Skyslope, which I'm going to dig or discuss with you briefly in a sec. So first off, I wanted to point out the apps icon on top. So here, this actually, when you click it, will allow you to switch from Skyslope transactions to forms or DigiSign. DigiSign is where you could set up documents for electronic signatures. So if you solely wanted to go and have any document signed, you can just click on DigiSign. It will prompt you to the DigiSign part of Skyslope. Forms, on the other hand, is a new feature added to Skyslope, which allows you to, instead of uploading different real estate forms, to just shop whatever forms you need for a transaction or any real estate documents that you need, which is usually issued by the board. But at this point, unfortunately, this is still not 100% completed for Saskatchewan. But I think in the next month or so, you'll be able to use this feature. Next off, we have the profile. I wanted to give a few minutes to go over the profile. Actually, when you do click on my account, it will just prompt you to your personal information and set your notification preference, your signature, your passwords, and other integrations. But what I wanted to point out on this page is that every Skyslope account comes with a special email that, if you use it, will automatically save any attachments or conversations inside Skyslope. And for Chris's account, Skyslope created Chris Molenaar 1 at skyslope.com. So whenever you use this email or send a document to this email, that document or conversation then will go to Chris's working document. So this one. So going back, since I was already talking about working documents, so say for example, I wanted to send out a copy of a purchase and sale agreement. So what happens is that if I send it to that special email, it will go to the working documents folder. And you will see the documents here, which you could organize by folder. So if you have, like, for example, a buyer's agreement and there's no property, there's no purchase yet, but they signed up an exclusive working relationship with you, then all you can do is add a folder or create a folder and add that document inside that folder. That way, once you have an agreement, all you can do is or assign that document to that particular transaction once a transaction is already created, so, like so. So as you see, I can just pick whichever folder I'd like that document to be assigned to, but I'm not going to do that right now. Then moving on, as you see, we have Manage Transactions. This folder is simply a quick overview for you to manage all your existing transactions. So when you click that, you'll be able to see a list of transactions. So we have here and their status and if how many items are incomplete and when is expected closing date. Then if there were any canceled transactions and then those that were closed and to be archived. So you can click from any of these folders if you want to access them and work with them. Then the next one is create transactions. So just like what I mentioned earlier, if you have a buyer and there is an accepted offer, or so what you need to do to start it off is to create a transaction. So you click on the plus sign and it will prompt you to the next or the information that you need to fill out. Skyslope is a very intuitive. All you have to do is to follow the prompts and you'll be able to create that transaction. I'm not gonna create any transaction at the moment. This is just a quick overview for now. All right, and then we have manage listings. So manage listings will be similar to manage transactions. Transactions are mostly created for buyer side. So once you do create transaction here, whatever is created will go to manage transactions. And then manage listings, on the other hand, is a summary of all the listings that's created. And to put a file in manage listings, so what you need to do is select the buyers, click on create listing. So when you do create a listing, it will also create that folder for you. And it will also prompt you to select buyers as to what you're going to do next. So that will be the page that you will be prompted to. Digital signature is DigiSign. So earlier, as you noticed, this is the quick link going to DigiSign, but you could also do that using this folder. So when you do click that, it will prompt you to a similar page. There you go. So check whatever's already been completed. You can also check the ones that's been sent, anything that's drafted. And you could also, this is where you're going to start whenever you'd like to send out a new set of documents for signature. You could also set up templates, like for example, a buyer's agreement or other forms that are typically used repeatedly. You can set up a template and have that pre-filled. So every time you have a new buyer, all you do is go to the templates, fill out the fields that's not going to be repetitive, like the name, the address, and other information, and then send it out. So actually, templates gonna make your signing process a bit more easy and breezy, because then you can put all documents that's repeatedly used and pre-fill the fields that are typically being filled out. And again, all gives you a summary of everything that's been processed in DigiSign. And now going back, we have incomplete checklist. This is just a quick overview of any checklists that's still incomplete or has any pending items in it. And then the closing dates. Then it separates transactions, which is on the buying side, and listing for the listing side. So you could also access that the folders from here. And then we have, of course, canceled contracts. It's just an overview or quick view of all canceled contracts. Access archives. These are typically the ones that's already completed. This is where everything about the transactions are saved. Then tasks and reminders. If you've set up your checklist to have reminders and other tasks, it will also prompt you on this folder. There you go. And you can sort them out. And before we working documents is one that I've already shown earlier. I wanted to do a quick overview on transactions, because this will be one of the folders that will be frequently used. So as you notice, we have some transactions that are still pending in here. So let's say we have 3220 11th Street with 6 items that are incomplete, and we have this set to close on the 28th of September. So when you go open this folder, it will actually show the details of this transaction. So you have the address, the acceptance date, and the details about the property. And the type of checklist that we're typically using for this case is this one. We name it this. And then the price, the closing date, then we have the names of the buyers, and then we have the agent information, the rest, and then the contacts, Then this is where we're also going to view the checklist. So the checklist is actually all the documents and the things that we need to complete to guide us with transaction, to make sure that we have everything all set prior to closing. And I also wanted to point out that for every transaction that we create, Skyslope also creates, you know, a unique email address for that particular transaction. So in this case, for this property, for this deal, we have 11th Street 322040 at skyslope.com. So similar to the personal unique email for every Skyslope account, whenever you use this email — this is, by the way, a working email — once you copy this email on all your communication, everything, communication and any documents that attach will be logged inside this folder, and it will keep all the documents and attachments inside the documents tab. So you can either do that or manually upload them. So anything that you also upload on the checklist will be saved here, which you can download or share or send it to an email as well. And then the logs will be, if there's any email sent out using this email, this is where you're gonna see it. All right. So, well, basically that's just about it with Skyslope. So I hope you were able to find bits of information that's helpful in your process. Thank you.